Hey everyone, welcome to another episode about my Lego vintage town that I'm building. In this episode we're gonna look at the lighting as I connected all the lights that are in the town. There are 63 light bricks at the moment and it looks kind of awesome, so I wanted to show you that later on, because first we're gonna have a look at the cleaning of the rail tracks, because there were a lot of remnants left of the rail gum that I used to get the track going again. And I use the compressor for that. Well, I wonder if the neighbors hear that. So, lighting. Like I said, I connected all the lights inside the town. And there's thermal blocks everywhere. But I hid them inside little Lego-made packages so you can't see them. So let's have a look at them. This is the amount of power that my Lego town lighting is drawing from this power supply. It's around 24-25 watts. And the town has in total 63 lights right now. It's going to be a bit more because I ordered some more on Bricklink because I wanted to add a few extra lights. But for now there are 63 and I'm going to kill the daylight light bulbs. So you can have a feeling of how it looks like. There we are. Now let's just walk around a bit. And as you can see, there are many lampposts. And I got also some buildings that I put lights in to make it look a bit better. So the downside of these 12 volt lights are that they aren't very strong. So you need a lot of lights to actually make it really look lighted everywhere, you know, because for example there are spots that are lighted very well. For example, the station here, you see there's a light brick there and there's one over there, and also let me search for it, there's also a light brick inside that level crossing building. So you know, they're perfect for that, but lighting a complete layout like I have here, it's a bit difficult. So am I disappointed? Yeah, just a little bit. It looks awesome, but I hope there was just a bit of additional light, because I still have one light on, and if I switch it off right now, you see it's completely dark, a bit too dark, and I don't know what it does to the camera with the grain. Because cameras in low light conditions, they have or grain and noise and stuff like that going on. So probably also with this camera right now, I can't see it on the screen. But what I'm gonna do is we're gonna first have a look at we're gonna walk through the city a bit, and after that we're gonna do a camera test and see how the camera actually performs in the manual settings. And see how much grain there is and see if we can filter it out in post-production, something like that, and have a look if I need to install another light or not. Not as big as this one here, but something smaller, just to have a few extra lux of light going on. So let's have a look at the city. You see there's still some damage from the hurricane that came through, that cleaned all the dust in the city. But the way it looks now, it's, yeah, I like it. Like, you see I put some lights in the parking garage and also under the gas station, so that looks very, very nice. So let's walk through a bit. So like I said, all the train sets have lighting. For example, this level crossing has lighting, and that level crossing has lighting also in the building. And yeah, it gives a general cool look, but it took also some time to actually build in all the lighting. And let's go to the industrial area over here. So we got some lighting going on with the container crane and the coal depot over there, and also the bridge has some lights, but you can't really see it very well. especially with this camera, because my eyes are seeing it very well, very clearly, but the camera doesn't. So yeah. So let's I always do that. Let's start running a train. I got one set up right here, and let's see how the camera performs in dark conditions with this light disabled. So I now set the camera manually, and I had to put it on ISO 800, and I believe I see a lot of noise and grain going on already. And I don't like the image of this because it's too dark. But let's see, let's run a train and let's see how it performs. Well, that's clear, you can't see anything. So let's put back on the main light a bit. The downside of the main light is that I'm directly below it, the main light, so it doesn't reach the end of the layout at the closets at the end over there. So it's darker over there. So next to that, I need to find a better spot to film the train, because you can't see it right now. So let's move. So I left the light in the room on now. I'm gonna run the train for a few rounds, and we're gonna compare it with and without noise reduction and stuff like that. Let's see what it does. Now let's test also some movements. Let's stop the train at the station. I don't have remote controls yet, so I can't really park it on the track at the platform, but this will do just fine. So I'm gonna have a look at the images we've just shot, and let's see how it looks. Alright, thank you for watching. That was it for today. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Like this video, subscribe if you haven't done so, to keep updated on this the progress on this town, because we're nearing the end a bit actually. Next episode will be about the remote controls that I'm going to install, with all the cable management that I talked about in a previous episode. I decided that the cables could be a bit visible, because yeah, those were visible also in the 80s, of course, and yeah, it gives a bit of an 80s look. So probably I'm gonna leave them along the tracks. You can see them, but in a very nice way, something like that. So more about that in the next episode. See you then. Bye.